stage. Behind us here we have Gary Lynch, who actually went to university, am I wrong, in Liverpool, and ended up a couple of years there, spending all his spare time teaching the kids of the branch, and with the lads, playing all the time with them. So thank you, Gary, for coming. We also have a man here who was pumped in last minute. I wanted, my original plan was my own son plays the piano, and the brilliant accompanist, and I thought that's a whole big circle, and you know, Mike Connor and the Liverpool, and man, I'm playing in Thailand then. He's in Thailand at the moment, you know. So we passed on each generation, you know. Sean Mack taught our bands when we were little toddlers, basically, you know. And then I went on teaching Céilí bands. It's rolled on, and these Liverpool sets are part of our DNA at this stage. So we got Paul Clesham, who is a friend of my best friend's son. Again, walked in just like a legend, playing with us. I mean, dancing at 5 o'clock this morning, and you know, dancing with me then at 5 o'clock in the Globe with the Moving Hearts. Totally change around from the Moving Hearts we have the Liverpool. I have here my brother-in-law, for want of a better name, Anthony McMahon, who plays all the Liverpool stuff. He used to hop up on the stage. That's where we met years and years ago. Not too many. And we have John Boyd, who is the husband of Geraldine Carter, who also would have played with the Liverpool as well. And I think back to here, and we have Jer and Mary, is that right, behind us, friends from Dublin. And I'm just going to introduce you to the youngest of the COYNEs, who used to be my set dancing partner at one stage. So here we have Terry COYNE.
Make it short, he said. I'm actually going to take you through a little passage which is basically brings us to where we are today. It's all about the journey for the Liverpool Céilí Band and its connection with Clare and its connection with Ennis. So the big days for me growing up was when we came over to the things like the Flanua, and then all of a sudden a little village called Kilmahill sprung up, and that basically just destroyed us for a few years. It's one of the most unbelievable times. So just a little extract, and I think there's a couple of quotes, one from Kieran Hamron, a great presenter and banjo player, and I think there's actually one of the barrows of this quote in here as well. So, if I can see.
Evidence.
So it's really about the times of in the 70s, the Flanua, and basically how a lot of us got to join the band and just jump up and play, and then the next thing it's just a party tradition. So it's, so the Flanua moved to Ennis in County Clare in 1974, and it continued to flourish. The band remained regular visitors to the festival alongside their old friends, the Kilfenora and the Tulla bands, who both came from the county. The fact that this festival is still going is a testament to the town of Ennis, and which is obviously our county town. It's always been a great place for music. I call it the Nashville, to be honest. If people don't know that much about traditional music and say, where you're going, I say, well, you know, you've heard of Nashville, well, that's where I'm going, but for Irish music, and that's where we are, in my opinion. So, Kieran Hamron, the musician broadcaster, conveys the feel of those early Flanua. He would be jumping up and playing tunes with us in those days. He said, some of my most wonderful memories as a youth in Ennis in the mid-70s are from the Flanua and the preparation that went on in the town in early May in anticipation of the final weekend of the month. Stages were built, halls readied, and the town was bedecked with bunting for what was always a good great celebration of traditional music, song and dance. Adding to that sense of expectation was the prospect of the legendary Liverpool Céilí Band arriving in town. We weren't short of Céilí Bands in Clare, but the Liverpool brought something different, exotic even. I knew it got from somewhere. And when they took the stage of the Jekyll, I mentioned earlier, with that exceptional sprung floor, which was perfect for dancing, it was really like, quite magical. And there was another venue that would always be associated with the band, in Ennis, as Donal actually quotes here, the Flanua has its base for us as a band in the Queen's Hotel. We stayed there for many, many years and made a mess of the place every May. After playing for the Ceili, we would gather in the bar and continue playing. We copious amounts of libation, I don't know what that means, but into the small hours and sometimes right the way through daybreak. And I saw many suns come up on the yard. This would be one of the great occasions of the reunion of the band in Ireland, when Kit, Charlie and Frank would link up with them again, and many other musicians. Like, we get together today, we haven't played together for donkey's years and it just seems like it's yesterday. They would head there to join the legendary sessions. There would be many supporters along with the musicians just wanting to be there, and a testament, you know, people who just come and just play. It's just about the spirit of the reels and about, you know, it's the love of the music. And I feel that the band basically extolled the virtue of, doesn't matter how good you are, doesn't matter what you play, get up and give it a go. And that's just the spirit we were brought up with. There'll be many supporters along with the musicians just wanting to be there because they knew there would be great music and craft at the Queen's. And Sean Mack often said that the Ceilis in Ennis were a particular delight to him. To see thousands dancing to your music in Ennis was fantastic. I mean, we were there in the heart of Clare and the music was great and our place was hopping. What became sort of synonymous with the band is its sense of fun. And they got well known for sort of singing along with the music. And if you ever remember the Dingle Regatta and you've been in the pub and going, hi, ho, that came from my dad and Sean Mack, that's where it originated, jumping up and down in the session. So we're going to give you one of our singing session sets, which is the Kilfenora jig, followed by the Dingle Regatta. And we expect you all to be singing and jumping out of your seats. Okay?